Hello students, I hope you are following my videos and concepts are very clear. Today we are going to discuss about laws of exponent for real number. So laws of exponents for real number, already laws of exponents are clear to you. Let's have a very short recap of what are laws of exponent. Like if we multiply 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 means what? How can we represent it in the shortest form? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It is 2 power 5. Clear? Which in turns is 32. Now here we say 2 as a base and 5 as a power or indices. This one, this concept is fixed only for 2. Now let's talk about generalization of this. This is regarding only one number. Now, when we talk of generalization, we will be taking variables and one variable and two variables. Let's see how they work. Hope you recover it from your previous classes. Already concept is taught to you. So, if it is a power m into b a power n, that means in one, bases are same. This is first law where bases are same and power is m and n. That means A multiplied M times and A multiplied N times. So, what it is? Multiplication is related to addition. So, bases taken as common and M plus N. Then, if second one, A power M divided by A power N. Clear? Here, it is division. Division is related to subtraction. So, this is A power m minus n, definitely when m is greater than n. What happens when m is less than n? In that case, this will be coming as a power negative. And to clear it, a power minus n is nothing but 1 by a power n. Clear? Now, fourth one is a power 0 is 1. And if we talk of fifth one, that is a power m into b power m. This says bases are different, multiply, but powers are same. In this case, the rule will be a into b power m. Isn't it? This is the fifth rule. Now, sixth one is a power m power n is equal to a power m n. Yes? Now, what is seventh one? Seventh one says, see, we have taken a, b, m, and n multiplied, powers are added. When it is divided, powers are subtracted. But be careful, m should be greater than n, then only this applies. If m is less than n, we will get a power as n. So, in that case, minus m minus this is, this will be coming as definitely a negative answer, which will give you negative answer means 1 upon a power n minus n, that is 1 upon a power n minus m. Clear? Now, a power 0 is 1. When two bases different, powers are same, we can multiply the bases and allot the same power. A power mn is a power m into n. Then, next few more to be taken. Now, the next one is, we can write it as a by b power m means a power m by b power m means if the numbers, two different numbers allotted with the same power, then we can write it as a power m and b power m. We are distributing the powers equally. Okay. Now, related to the power and exponent, the most important concept which we are going to take for a real number, where a is greater than 0, p and q are integers and having no common factor, obviously q is greater than 0. In such a case, we need to manipulate the, we will be applying these laws in our problem for solving it based on the requirement of the question. Now, what is this? A power p by q. As the seventh law I have explained you, a by b whole power m means we are independently allotting a power m upon b power m. Similarly, here it is p by q. Now, what happens if the power is, till now we have seen all the powers to be only in the same form. Now, it is in the rational number form. Now, if the powers are in whole number form, we have seen all the seven laws. Clear? We are going to see when the power will be in the rational number form. For rational number, what is the condition? It should be in the form of p by q. P by q is already there. Then, q is greater than 0. There it is, q is not equals to 0. But here the condition is, being not equal to 0, it is greater than 0. Clear? Now, p and q are integers. One more important concept is, the power should have no common factor. Means p by q is not having any other factor other than 1. Clear? In such a case, we can write it as a power p by 1 by q. See, p into 1 by q is nothing but again p by q. Clear? So, we are not changing what is given. We are just modifying it. A power p whole power 1 by q can be written as 1 by q is nothing but qth root by under a power p. And the second one is, or we can rearrange it as a power 1 by q whole power p, which will say that qth root of a whole power raised to p. Both the cases are same. It can be represented other way round. When a is greater than 0, p and q are integers, q is greater than 0 and p and q have no other common factor. Now, to continue with the same exponent rules for real numbers, when we are talking about root. Now, here we are saying nth root of a power n is equal to a. How it is? To explain, it is a power n, and what is nth root in the previous, just few minutes before I've explained, it was 1 power n. That means this is a power n by n, and n by n is nothing but 1. So, if the power is mentioned or not mentioned, it is expected that this is a power 1. A power 1 is what? Multiplying a 1 times. So, you will get it as a only. Now, the second rule here, extended rule, says root, nth root of a and nth root of b, two different numbers having the same nth root, will be written as a common root given with n as independent one and a and b. The third one says pth root of a power n and pth root of a power m. Here roots are same, numbers are a and a, numbers are also same. Here the numbers were different. Here the bases are same and we are have the power different. So, in such a case, we will again go back to the basic laws that says n minus m. And this one root is, pth root is common. Now, when we take for fourth law, it is explained as both are having nth root, numbers are a and b, nth root. In that case, a power m into a power n, b power n. Was both are having n, so we have written it as product of ab power n. Here we are explaining it as nth root of a and b, product of ab. Now, mth root of nth root of a. The simplification you have seen bracket of bracket. In such a case, both are having m and nth root, bases are same. So, we can multiply the powers and allot the same root, and or we can interchange it for further clarification, that is nth root of mth root of a. Now here it is pth root of a power n into a power m. Again basic rule applies, pth root remain the same, a power n into a power m is a power n plus m. And pth root of a power n whole power n gives you pth root of a upon product of n into m. Clear? Let's see some application of laws on problems. Now, this is x power cube square root of 2/3. Now how it can be written? This is x. Clear? 3. When you remove this root, you will get half. Overall, you have 2/3. Now this is written as x 3/2 whole power 2/3, which will give you x 3/2 into 2/3. 2 cancel, 3 cancel. X power 1 is x. Clear? So we are using how many rules here? First, we have removed the root, applied it as 1/2. Then we have found the product m into n. Product is 3/2. Again, power of power, which I have explained in the last one. Now we have taken it and simplified it as x. Let's go to the second problem. In the second problem, we have seen the application of laws of exponent and extended laws of exponent. 2 power 0, that is a power 0. What was the value? A power 0 is 1. And 7 power 0 is also 1. And 5 power 0 is also 1. So 1 plus 1 is 2. 2/1 is 2. Let's take few more practical applications. Now we will take two more examples. 16 1/4 and 16 power minus 1/4 into 4th root of 16. We can see that the bases are same. We are not going to disturb the base. We will be multiplying it and we will be rewriting it in the other form. Now here bases are same. 16 power 1/4 plus 1/4. One is positive, the other one is negative, same values. So this will be as 16 power 0, which is 1. Now 81 power 0.16 into 81 power 0.19. Clear? Now what we will do, bases are same. We are going to just add the powers. This is 0.16 plus 0.9. And 0.16 and 0.09 will give you 81 power 0.25. Now how are you going to multiply 81.25 times? So what we will do is, we will write it as 81. This will be 25/100. Clear? Now this 25/100 can be written as 81 power 1/4. Now to further simplify, 81 can be expressed as a power of 4. Can you think of? Yes. That's 3 power 4. Now 3 power 4, 1 power 4. Again we will multiply the powers. 4 into 1/4 is 1. So this will come as 3, 4 into 1/4, which will give you 3 power 1. Nothing but 3. Clear? Now let's take few more examples. Like 5th. Now let's take 5th problem. Now 5th problem is 16 power half whole power half. So how we are going to solve? 16 power half into half will give you 16 1/4. Now to further solve this, we will express 16 as power of 4. Now how can we write it? See, 2 into 2 is 4. 2 into 2 is 4. 4 into 4 is 16. 2 power 4 will give you 16. So 2 power 4 whole power 1/4. Again it will come as 2 power 1, that is 2. Now next example, 6th one, is 64/25. See, here we don't have any other laws. Either you can go for 64. Independently you can allot the power and solve. But we will be not making it much more complex, easier. How can we make it easier? See, this is having 2. That means if you further see it in deep, it is square root of 64/25 - 3. Clear? Power is minus 3. So we will try to arrange the given numbers in form of square. So how can we write? See, this is 8 square, 64. This is 5 square, whole power minus 3/2. Which can be written as 8/5 power 2 whole power minus 3/2. Which will be 8 by 5 power 2 into minus 3 by 2. That is 8 by 5 power minus 3, as 2 and 2 gets cancelled. Now what is a power minus m? I have explained in the basic law. It was 5 by 8. Reverse it here itself. Now 5 cube is 5 5 is a 25. 25 5 is a 125. Clear? 8 8s are 64. And 64 multiplied by c. 8 cube. 8 8s are 64. 64 into 4 is 4 4s are 16. 24 and 125. This is 256. So this is your final answer. Now we will take up one more example. Now another example where we can say the bases are same, powers are again in variable form, not in numbers, and that too subtracted. Now by seeing the question, it looks a bit complicated what to do and what not to do. But have patience, just apply the rule and the answer will be quickly in front of you. So what it is, x power, see all the bases are same and they are multiplied. So what we will be doing, we will be adding the power as per the rule, clear? Now further simplify it, a minus b plus b minus c plus c minus a. Now as I told you not to be so thinking what to do and what not to do. Now it's easy. We have just applied the rule and we have added the powers. Now we can see a minus a, minus b plus b, minus c plus c. Each power has its own additive inverse present there. So this will become 0 because a will be cancelled by minus a, b will be cancelled by plus b, and c can be cancelled by plus c. Clear? So we have x power 0, that is 1. Now let's see this one. Next example. 3 power 2 by 3 and 3 power 1 by 5. Now again the bases are same. We cannot further simplify 3. Now we will be adding the powers as this is multiplied. So this is 1 by 5. Now 3 power, the LCM will become 15. 5 2s are 10. 10 plus 3. This is 3 power 13 by 15. We have seen many simple applicable problems. Now see bit complicated and using the extended laws of power and exponent. Now extended laws of power and exponent. See, this problem though looks very complicated, but start with the extended laws. How to start with? See, first write x square. Remove this root. This will become 1 by 3, isn't it? Let this fourth root be present here. Now, x power 2 by 3 and fourth root. Now, x 2 by 3 power 1 by 4 will give you x 2 by 3 into 1 by 4, which will give you x 2 by 12. Here, this is x square, this is 1 by 3, this is 4th root as it is written. Now, 2 into 1 by 3 is 2 by 3. Now, this 4th root is written as 1 by 4. 2 by 3 into 1 by 4 is this. Clear? So, we have solved this. Let's go for the next one. 32 upon 243. We don't have any other laws to be applicable there. The only form is we need to rearrange 32 and 243. How to rearrange? In a power of 5. Clear? So, we know that 2 power 5 is 32. What about 243? Yes, it can be written as 3 power 5. Clear? Now whole power is minus 1 4 by 5. 2 by 3 whole power 5 into minus 4 by 5 will give you 2 power 3 power minus 4, which is 3 by 2 power 4. Now 3 by 2 power 4 is 3 3 is a 9, 9 3 is a 27, 27 3 is a 81 by 2 power 4 is 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8, 8 2's are 16. Clear? Now, these were a few simple problems. Let's check for one complicated problem. Now, let's, as I told us, one complicated one where we need to apply many rules and solve this problem. This is simplified. Now, this is 5 multiplied by 8 power 1 by 3 plus 27 1 by 3. If we recall the cause and exponent laws, we don't have any laws related to addition. So what we will be doing, and as per simplification part, we need to solve the brackets first. So let's start with 5 into 8 can be written as 2 power 3 whole power 1 by 3 plus this can be written as 3 cube whole power 1 by 3 overall 1 by 4. Now 3 into 1 by 3 will become 2 power 1. 3 into 1 by 3 will become 3 power 1. So this can be written as 2 plus 3 and 5. This whole bracket means everything is to the power of 1 by 4. Now this becomes 5 into 5, clear? Power 1 by 4, which is 5 square power 1 by 4. And this is 5 1 by 2. Now 5 1 by 2 is nothing but square root of 5. Problem which started with a bit confusing one came to be very easy solution. Now only patience and memorization of laws will help you solve the problem. Clear? Let's take one more example. Next example, where 4th root of 81, x power 8, y power 4 and z power 16. Now, even the variables have the power. We have a number and whole is applied to the 4th root. Let's see now what can be the solution. So, as we have seen one of the rules, nth root of a power n and b power b. So what we did, we independently allotted it as the powers. Clear? So the same rule we are going to apply here. This is power 1 by 4, x 8, 1 by 4, y to the power, y to the power 4, 1 by 4 into z 16 power 1 by 4. Clear? Now, 81 can be expressed as power of 4? Yes, it is 3. 3 power 4 whole power 1 by 4. X 8 into 1 by 4. Y 4 into 1 by 4. Z 16 into 1 by 4. Now, this is 4 into 1 by 4. 1, x, 8 and 4 will be cancelled. So, 4 2's are 2. Y, 4 and 4 cancel, 1. Z, 4 and 16 cancel, 4. So, the final answer is 3x square y z power 4. Clear? Now, hope you have understood the problem. Only applying the rules will lead to correct solution. Have patience, recall the rules and solve. Let's see one more example. Now, our last example for today's class, it is 8 power 2 by 3 minus square root of 9 into 10 power 0 plus 1 upon 144 right, minus 1 by 2. Now, to simplify well, 8 can be expressed as a power of 3. Clear? This 9 can be expressed as 3 power 2 whole power 1 by 2. 10 power 0 is 1. Plus 1 by 144 can be written as 1 by 12 power 2, whole power 1 by 2. Clear? Now, here this is 2 power 3 into 2 by 3 is 2 power 2 minus 3 power 2 into 1 by 2 multiplied by 1 will be as 1 plus 12 power minus 2 whole power minus 1 by 2. When a power minus n can be written as 1 by a power n. So, a power 1 by a power n can be written as a power minus n. So, we have used that rule here. Now, this simplification 2 square, this is 3 into 1 is 3 plus 12 minus 2 into 1 by minus 1 by 2. So, this 2 and this 2 cancels. This will become plus. So, we have 4 minus 3 plus 12. If you recall integer, plus 4 minus 3 is 1 plus 12. The answer is 13. So, dear students, I tried to take more number of examples so as I could explain you the applications of all the extended laws of power and indices. So, for today, let's stop the class today. Thanks for now. We will meet very soon with next topic.